In this video, I will show you how to use Reclaim AI. So Reclaim AI is a scheduling tool that helps you schedule for the perfect work week. And here are some things that they do. They help you with your habits, tasks, the calendar sync, buffer time, smart one-on-ones, and scheduling links. Now I'll show you exactly how you can use Reclaim AI specifically with Google Calendar, although Outlook Calendar is also coming soon, so at the time you're watching this video, Outlook Calendar may already be available. So if you want to get started with Reclaim AI for free, you can use the link down in the description, and once you click on that link, you will be taken to this page. Now here, simply click on free on Google Calendar, or if you want to use it with Outlook Calendar and that is available, you can also choose that option. Now I'm just going to use it with Google Calendar for now. Now after you click right here, you need to choose a Google account that you want to use it with. So then you will be taken to the onboarding. So now here, simply click on continue in the bottom right. Now you want to connect your work calendar. So click connect work calendar and again choose your Google account. Now your calendar has been connected. So this is the primary calendar you will block time on. So they do recommend using your work calendar where the most action is. So now you need to follow a few more steps. So what brings you to Reclaim? I will say team or company use, then what best describes your role. I will select manager. Now what is your department? Select your goals. And now here you can set up some habits. So these are some habits that you already have or that you want to have. So for example, lunch 30 minutes to 1 hour every day, and then you can just block this in automatically. So just choose whatever habits you would like to add in, and these are some popular templates, but after creating your account, you can explore over 100 templates from your habits page. So for example, I will just add in morning catch-up. So then click continue. Now you can auto schedule buffer time. So this is some time in between your appointments where you have, for example, 5 or 10 minutes to, as it says right here, decompress. So you can have decompression time right here. So you can schedule a 15 minute break after meetings with video conference links, or you can choose travel time where you add a 30 minute buffer before and after events with a location. So I will turn on both of these. So then click continue. And now you may want to create a team, so you can invite your coworkers to your team to get the most out of Reclaim. So simply search or enter an email right here and go ahead and invite them. Now if you don't want this, just click on finish in the bottom right and then you will have set up your account. So now you will be taken into the dashboard right here, where you have a 14-day free trial. So now you can just explore it, and I'll show you how you can use it for your scheduling as well. So first I'm going to go over to the planner right here, since this is where most of the stuff that you want to do happens. So you can see the time in the left right here. So the morning catch-up, it says for every single day, is from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. and you can see the time that it is right now. So right now it's a little after 10 a.m. and you can see that this right here, morning catch-up, when you click on it, is from 8 a.m. until 10 a.m. right now. Now you may want to set this to a different time. So what you can do is just click on it in the future right here, and you can just click on the edit icon in the top right here, and then just select the time. So it only takes 15 minutes for this, so I will select 8 a.m. until 8:15. And now you can just click on copy to all right here, and now it will all be set to this time. So then click save. And now you can see that on your calendar, this will move up and it becomes smaller because the time frame is a lot smaller. Now what you can simply do if you want to add multiple tasks here is click in the top right on new task. There's also a shortcut for this. You can just click C on your keyboard. And now here you want to give the task a name, for example, competitor research. Then you can give it a duration. So for example, 1 hour. Or 1 hour 30 minutes, 2 hours, whatever you want. I'll set it to 1 hour and 30 minutes. Now you can set it to split up, and as you can see, when I turn this off, this disappears, and this right here is a minimum and maximum duration. So it will take at least 30 minutes and no more than 2 hours, but probably 1.5 hours. I'll just turn this on since I can choose how long I want to do this. Then for the hours, I will select working hours. And now you can choose when you want to schedule this. So right now it's the 25th. I'm going to set it to the 26th right here. Now you can click create. And now you will see it right here. Now you can just drag this over to wherever you want to add it in. So also whatever time frame. For example, if I want to do this tomorrow at 10 to 11:30, I can just add it in right there or right after my morning catch up. And then you will see the time right there. So creating tasks is really simple, and this will also show up in your Google Calendar. Although Reclaim AI has a bunch more features. When we head over to the priorities section right here, you can see your priorities. So reclaim schedules based on what's important to you. Priorities allows you to set different levels of urgency for your calendar events, from low, before, to critical P1. So for example, this task right here, when we click on this task, you can set the priority level by clicking right there on the priority. So you have low priority, medium priority, high priority, or critical. I will set this to medium, and now it will schedule that based on the priority level. So it's probably smart to have the highest priority tasks in the morning when you are fresh, and then the medium priority later in the day. Now, if you want to set the priority immediately when creating the task, then when you click new task in the top right, you can select the priority level right here. So if I set this to critical and click create, you will now see the task right here. And when you click on it, you will see in the top right, the priority level is critical. Now here you also have the stats section where you can see your time breakdown. So what you are spending the most time on, your time breakdown trend. So also how much you're working in general, your habits and tasks. So what tasks are you doing the most and what are you spending the most time on? You can see the amount of time you spent on meetings, how many people you have met with, your work-life balance right here, and your focus time. So after you've been using Reclaim AI for some time, you will see those stats right here. I also have your team stats, so if you have invited your team, you can see what your team is doing with their time right here. Now here in the tasks section, you can see all of your tasks that have to be done. So for example, the competitor research one is due tomorrow, and you can see the time right there and how long it will take and the priority level. Now if you add in team members, they will also see this right here, and they can see what they need to do. Now you also have your habits right here. So if you want to create a habit that you do every day so that you don't need to schedule that every single day, you can click new habit in the top right. Then choose the habit right here, for example, lunch. Then you can choose the priority. I will set this to low priority. Then you can give it a color. For example, I'll make this yellow. Then you can choose solo work or personal. For me, this is personal. Now you can choose how long it takes. So I will just set this to, for example, 30 minutes to 45 minutes. And for hours right here, I will just keep this on one off hours. Now here you want to choose at what date you want this to be, at what time you want this to be. So I'll select, for example, 12, 45 until 1:30. So now you can click copy to all right there, and now you will have set the lunch to 5 days a week at these times right here. So then that will be scheduled in automatically every single day. Now you have some more settings that you can choose right here. So the visibility, the time defense, so how aggressively should Reclaim defend this habit on your calendar. So for example, if something else comes up, you can set it to always free, and then something else will go above this and your lunch will be gone. So if you do want to have lunch every single day, you can set it to always busy, or you can use Reclaim's AI. So Reclaim will automatically schedule events for this habit and set them to either free or busy based on the habit's priority level and overall availability. So I'm going to use Reclaim's AI since this is a great tool. Now you can set notifications for this event. I don't need this. Now here you also have some advanced options, which I don't need. I'll just click on save now. And now when I go back to my planner here, you will now see that lunch happens every single day. Now you can see right here that the time is not what I filled in, and it's a little bit different every day. That's because Reclaim AI schedules it whenever it fits best. So as you can see, this is a little bit early, so you can just set this to later by clicking edit. And here you can choose the ideal times. Right now it's set to 9 a.m. but for example, if we set this to 1 p.m. and then click save, you will see that now it all moves to 1 p.m. So for example, if you set the ideal time to 9 a.m, then it will put it as close as possible to 9 a.m. So that's a useful feature of Reclaim AI. If something doesn't work out perfectly, then the AI feature will just put it as close as possible to when you want to do it. So if you want to put in the habits, just go to habits right here. And another useful feature is the template section right here. So for example, if I want to add in 2 to 4 hours of focus time every day and put this to high priority, then I can do that as well. So for example, I will set this to purple. Now you can choose the duration, so 2 to 4 hours. And now you can choose a time frame that you want this to happen in. Now if it doesn't matter for me, so I can just set it from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. whenever I have time, then I'll do it like that. Now you can choose the ideal time. So for me, it's early in the morning, and I will select 8 a.m. So then hit save right here. And now when I go back to my planner here, you can see when it will schedule this in. So you can see the focus time is scheduled in as close to 8 a.m. as possible. So here on these days, I didn't have anything, So then it has moved as close as possible right here. Now you can see what happens on this day right here. The launch moves all the way up to 8:30 until 9 a.m. So that's of course not really a launch. So you can simply move this behind that so that you then have the launch after your focus time. Now the morning catch-up, as you can see, disappears in all of these days. That's because the focus time right here has a higher priority. As you can see, the morning catch-up here has a priority of medium, but the focus time has a priority of high. So the high priority task goes above the medium priority task. Now if you want to have the morning catch-up always and you don't want it to disappear like this, then what you can do is go back to habits here, then select the habit, so for me it's this one. Go ahead and click on it, then click edit right there. So then once you're in the settings for the habit, just select the time frame right here. Now what I did is set the time frame from 8 a.m. to 8:15. So that means that the task can only be done within this time frame. Now I'm going to change this to something different. So for example, I'll set it from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. and copy this to all. So now the time that this can be done in is larger. Now when I click save and go back to my planner, you can see that it still doesn't show up because these tasks take a lot of time from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. So if you want to make these a bit shorter so that you have time for the other things, what you can do is go back to habits, select the focus time right here, then click on the three dots and click edit. And now for the time right here, I'm just going to set it to max 2 hours and minimum 1 hour. So then I'll click save. And now when I go to my planner and wait a second, you can see that now it is from 9 to 11 a.m. and now we do have time for the morning catch up. Now if you want the morning catch up to be before the focus time, which I do want, then what I'm going to do is go to habits right here and just set the morning catch up to critical priority so that it is always at the time I want. And the ideal time is 8 a.m. as you can see right there. So now when I go to my planner, the morning catch up will always come in front of the focus time, as you can see right here. So we start right here at about 9 a.m. with the morning catch up. Now I want this to be 8 a.m. so I'm just going to change this real quick. And now it moves up to 8 a.m. So you can see how easy this tool works. Now if something else comes up, you have a meeting for example, you can click new task, select meeting about for example marketing, whatever you do, then set the duration to for example 1 hour, minimum 30, maximum 2 hours. Then for the hours, select working hours, then select a date, so when it is. For example, I will select the 27th of March, and then for the time, I will select 3 p.m. So this is when it's due. Now you want to schedule it also the same date. If you want to have it the 28th, then you want to select that as well. So now there's probably a set time that this needs to happen. So for example, if this happens at 3 p.m. then you can just set it to 3 p.m. right here, and then you can see it right here. So schedule after this time, then click on create. And now you can see that on the 28th, on Thursday that is, you can see you have this meeting right here and it schedules it in automatically. And now you want to set the priority for this to critical because this cannot be moved. So it's all pretty simple. Now you also have your smart one-on-ones right here, so you can automatically find time for your one-on-one. So click new smart one-on-one, then search or enter an email for a person you want to have a one-on-one with, and then it will match up your agendas and see when you both have time for a one-on-one call. So that's pretty simple. Now you also have smart meetings right here, and this is not yet available, but it is coming soon. So this helps you auto-schedule your recurring team meetings at the best time for everyone. Now you also have the calendar sync, so you can start syncing your calendars with other people, and you have scheduling links, so you can create a link and people can then schedule in a time when you are available. So Reclaim AI is a great tool to help you prioritize the work that's most important and make sure that that gets done every single day. So again, if you want to claim your 14-day free trial, you can use the link down in the description to get started. And after the 14-day free trial, you can see that the free plan is also available right here, where you get up to one user, one scheduling link, 3 habits, 1 calendar sync, 3 weeks out, and 2 connected calendars. Now the cheapest plan, which is recommended, starts at 8 euros per user per month when built yearly. So you can see that then it moves up to 10 users. So if you have a team, this is much better. You can also schedule out further up to 8 weeks, and in this plan even 12 weeks. So you can get started for as cheap as 8 euro per user per month. Now when you click see all features, you will see which features are exactly included in each of these plans. Now personally, I do use the starter plan right here. So now you know how to use Reclaim AI. If this video was helpful, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to my channel. And with that being said, I will see you in the next video.